We got another Marlin on the table. This is a 1971 Marlin with no cross bolt safety with chamber issues. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Alright, so what's up guys? I know it's been a while, been real busy, but I picked this old Marlin up on trade the other day, and it's got some chamber issues. I fired two rounds off of it today, and the brass was swole where it would not eject easily. So I'm going to show you some brass here. If you can tell how swole right here at the back sides, both of these brass. If you can tell how swole them are, make sure y'all are in camera. So if you can see how swole that is, and what I'm thinking about doing, either one or two things, re-barrel it, or see if I can polish this part of the chamber out. Now, as far as the brass being reloadable, I don't know whether that's gonna be reloadable once I polish this swell here out or not. It's heavy on one side, but I think if I can just polish this out, this back part of the chamber, if I can polish that out, that what I'll have is just a easy for it to extract, because this size in the chamber is not swelling, so it has to get over this hump right here. So if I'm gonna polish this out, again, the brass may end up not being reloadable, but at least the gun will function normally. So we've already checked it for safety, so we're gonna strip her down and get to work on her. So look, to keep the oil and stuff like that off the gun, I'm just gonna go ahead and strip it all the way down, take the bolt and everything out of it, remove the stocks and stuff like that, because my plan is to run a dowel rod into this chamber here with some in a drill, and have some sandpaper on the side, on the inside right here, and just a little bit of oil, and just sit there and run that drill until the swollen shell will fall right in. If the swollen shell will fall in, that means that this hump here, or the material in the chamber right here, is gone, and this shell should fall right on in. Because right now, and I'll show you what I'm talking about once I get it apart. So let's just go ahead and remove the screws. So there we go. totally stripped except for the loading gate, which is just a piece of blue spring steel held on by that screw. We ain't worried about taking that out right now, or probably won't take it out. So what I was telling y'all about this swole brass here, I believe that one was the one I had already tried, so we're not going to use that one. We're going to try to stick this one in there, and it should not fit. It should, like, right there. That joker's not going in there right now. That is tight. That's as far as it wants to go without forcing it. I mean, I closed the bolt on this one. That's why I didn't want to use it. So, and what that done when closing the bolt, kind of resized it, cut it off this hump here. So what I want to do, like I said, is take this dowel rod, take me some sandpaper and some oil, put it on a drill, and go in here and polish this chamber just on the end where this shell did not swell or did not conform to the chamber. Now, like I said before, this brass is probably ruined, but it's just brass. I may not be able to reload it. I don't know. I might be able to reload it after I've shot it in this rifle, but we'll just have to wait till we get to the reloading bench and we'll see. So what I want to do now is set up my drill and get me some sandpaper, like I said, on this old dowel rod right here, and see if we can't polish this joker up. So hang with me just a little bit. Went and found me some more sandpaper. This is 120 grit. I've decided against the dowel rod, seeing I broke it. I found this in my box there. All right, real quick, because my phone's about to die.
I just got done polishing the chamber, and you can see that swell, very pronounced swell right there on that brass. This is Federal brass. Come on. Swell, Federal brass. So I got the reloading dies out, and I'm gonna see if they'll resize. I'm gonna go shoot these again. So stay tuned. All right, I just reloaded these two shells. The swell is still there, but the resizer didn't seem to mind, so if it doesn't mind, I don't either. Let's go shoot them. So here goes the function test with the two reloads. Shooting into an old dead tree here. Looks like they work.
Every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And we're gone.